No artificial lighting this time. Got some sunset rainbows going. I guess they're not rainbows exactly, but you know what I mean. Though I'm a little emotional and I wouldn't normally choose to record in this unsettled state, yet I'm such a sucker for these colors. They just exalt me somehow. They just lift me up. So beautiful. Somehow they feed the soul. I've gotten permission to upload a video I found on Dimitri Halley's website. It's a piece of his work, presented in a classroom. And at first you may hold back because it's subtitled, and in this one he's not speaking English. But I want to set it up for you so that not that you need me to do this, my friends. It's just that it moved me enough. So I did a little road up to go with it, write up to go with it. On 11:15, I wrote this. That it was the first thing I wrote that day, and the Mayan day was for read. And it's in the Embracing the Shadow series. And this is his title: What Stops Us from Doing What's Right. Oh my God, just look at the depth of that right there. And please drop into heart. I'm not sure it's soup yet, by which I mean that which is swimming around in heart. I don't know if it's quite ready or complete enough to take on my next project, which is this introduction to a Dimitri Halley upload. It's only two short videos, which I joined into one called What Stops Us from Doing What's Right, and it's very powerful stuff. I'm most excited he was generous enough about sharing his work, and I know you'll be pleased. Dimitri is from Aruba, a psychologist and a teacher as well. And this is a taped excerpt from a class he taught. And now, before you nod off or click off in boredom, if you'll just listen to it from heart, you may be truly amazed. Dimitri shares a penetrating vision of just what is wrong, just what stops us from doing what is right, which we don't always do in spite of our best intentions or the very real desire to do so. Everyone knows that. Yet, how many know why? While the subject of the class is ethics, it goes to the root, or to the heart of something so very critical and quite missing from our society around the world today. We don't have sufficient self-awareness to keep the self in check or to see that we're creating our world. This is nothing like any ethics class you may have had in university, my friend. Nothing like. He gets immediately right to the point, the meat and the bone of the issue. Why don't we do what is right? What stops us? What's wrong with our vision overall that the world should be in such a state? Do you know? What's your answer? Do come and see the answer, the guidance given by or through Dimitri. His perceptions are, as I said, penetrating and deep. They cut to the quick, the error of the educational system and the classical or typical way of presenting this and all other subjects. Now, it will help if you are at least aware of the quantum physics observation problem and the part that it plays in how we create, based on our unconscious beliefs, the reality we experience. Though this isn't strictly necessary to understand this video, it's explained pretty well here. It's just that this observation problem goes so deep that it takes some getting used to the new way of seeing that enters when you recognize it. Its implications are terribly vast. It takes you on a journey of adjustment. Have you ever been in denial about anything? Do you know others who are? In this short video, you will see deeply into what's under it, what causes it, at least what underlies it. Once understood, at least perceived, such things tend to vanish on their own. It's all part of becoming more self-aware. And that's what Dimitri here helps us to do. So, the seeing comes first. Then, once we've seen, it is time to enter our life with the new vision we've received. This sort of change in vision tends to turn our old view of life on its head. Disconcerting, it will be. It can take some getting used to. We're not used to taking responsibility for our own life, and that's a fact. We've been well schooled in how not to do that. Well, thanks, Source, we are awakening. Those of us who are ready for this, and you know who you are. You can take responsibility for that as well. Choice lies at the heart of it. Let's make it informed choice, though. Our educational system has worked hard to deliver a dumbed-down populace. Well, step right down out of that, down from the head into the heart, and put your heart vision to work. You're not dumb in the least. Don't fall for it. Now, I'm going to step out of this journal here for just a minute. I'm not saying the teachers are dumb. I'm not saying even the administrators are behind this. This is just a big systemic thing that is behind the running of everything. And you have to go pretty far up the food chain before you find those whose intent it is to create this. So, all right. Sure, you may have some catch-up work to do to learn about things you weren't taught in the schools. Well, that will be much more enjoyable for you doing it under your own steam and without an obfuscating curriculum and teacher to misguide you. For now, this must be the better way to learn. At least you learn something. Be self-guided. It's time we all began finding and trusting the inner, the deeper, the transcendent self a good bit more. You can more easily do that when you have ample knowledge and understanding like that given through Dimitri's work. The portal he opens into the inner workings of the self is tremendous. It's not the whole thing, by far. No one has that. But what he offers is powerful stuff. Stuff you won't find elsewhere that I know of. Transformative. That's what this is. I hope you will get past the fact that it is subtitled in English as it's given in his native tongue at the University of Aruba. Nor will you be able to take it all in with one viewing. It's short enough, but the material is so transformative that you'll bring a new self, a new understanding to further viewings. The stuff is deep. In this short show, he can only skim the surface of things. It does the trick, however, for this reason. It opens the portal to you. It gives you a clearer vision of just what is acting there in your life. With that vision, the journey is on. You can forge ahead under the tutelage of the inner teacher, the counselor, the guide we all have, as I say, in heart. But that's a concept, I know, and not the only way to see this. See it your very own way. Just get to the meat of it, whatever you do. Cease being satisfied with the scraps, the superficial skin, the surface of such things. Go for the gusto. Be willing to change, to be changed, to be made over in a higher image of self, and that's what's available here. And of course, I recommend Dr. Halley's work more widely than just this one small show. The links to it and my playlist are, well, you know, I haven't made a playlist. I'll link you to his site, are both in these videos and in the transcript or notes on Scribd. Be blessed, my friends. If you're truly seeking self, higher self, deeper understanding, this is the way to go. Let this be one stop along your way. Enjoy the show.